Oh, Sim Shady here. Not often that I do a voiceover, but I think there's definitely a need since Flyiniron have released an update to their very popular, and rightly so, Spitfire Mark 9. Now, this is a update that is currently only available directly from their website, and it's only available to aircraft that has been purchased directly from their website. The update will come to the Flight Sim Store purchased version of this aircraft, but don't know what the time scale is with that. But I think I should show you what to expect, and also give a little video on how to handle this aircraft on the ground. I do still see people being ginger with the throttle because it will still want to veer off the centre line. So I have a couple of techniques to help you get past that. So we'll turn the master on and get the mixture rich. Fuel is already on. We need to build fuel pressure via the wobble pump. Now, the aircraft hasn't been started, but fuel pressure was still good. With the temperature the way it is at the moment, I will give this 10 primes. Oh. Six, seven, eight. 9, 10, and we shall lock that off. Turn the mags on, crack the throttle a little bit. We do have our park brakes on. We'll hold the stick back and we shall go for a start. Now, energize the coils first. And then we'll go for a start and see if she'll fire. There she goes. So, close our door. I like to double latch it. We'll close these off. And we'll get up before the sun sets. Now, the winds are favouring 806. Runway takeoff. Now it is a fully castoring tailwheel on the Spitfire, so asymmetric braking is advised.
Ground Golf Kilo request taxi for takeoff, departing straight out.
And a bit of power as well.
Golf Kilo Taxi 2 and hold short of runway 06 right using taxiway Charlie Bravo Alpha. Contact tower on 122.08 when ready.
Taxi, hold short runway 06 right using taxiway Charlie Bravo Alpha Golf Kilo.
So, a lot of you will already know this, but a lot of starboard or right rudder is your friend. If you add your perhaps going off the taxiway there a bit. Reset your rudder trim so port is at the top, and it should be sufficient. Just remember to back that off once you're airborne. Now, takeoff power is going to be full RPM, and we'll get the boost no more than 12. Your boost gauge is here. I think that might be 12 pounds. Being a tail dragger, I've got a nose in the way, so best to get your head out the cockpit, keep the cockpit canopy open. If you don't have such luxury as track IR or VR. And the best thing you can do is to zigzag down the taxiway, but it's still quite difficult to see out of. Well, as one click of nose up, I better call for clearance before I'm told off.
Gulf Kilo ready for departing straight out at runway 06 right.
Gulf Kilo altimeter, tree 0.271 comm straight out, departure approved. Cleared for takeoff runway 06 right.
Cleared for takeoff runway 06 right, Gulf Kilo.
I don't know why the sim always thinks my pilot is a female, but there you have it. But the best method with the elevation on the ground is to keep a good amount of back pressure. I'll just get that wobble pump up a bit before I lose the engine. Yeah, back pressure just ensures that you have less chance of nosing the aircraft over. Now, with the rudder trim set to port to starboard, there is still a need to nurse the aircraft just to stop any potential ground loops. Also, it is advised being slow with the throttle, as you can induce so much lift over the tail it'll nose over. But we have a clear runway, clear view, and we'll go for takeoff power. Now, holding the back pressure on, as soon as the airspeed comes alive, then we'll let it go, and the tail should come up. There's 12 pounds on the boost, and she wants to go flying. Around about 100 foot, or when the gear comes up, bring your RPM down to 2600. Close your canopy, and then you can get rid of the rudder trim. I'm going to do a quick set of right hand circuit. I have got headphone simulation turned on, purely and simply because without it, I don't think you'd hear me. But the sounds of this aircraft are much improved. It seems as though now you have a much more guttural sense of that Merlin up front. Prop sounds have been added also, and there has been some tweaks to the way the wing sounds now under load, which we've got some room. We'll put the nose down and we'll do a quick loop. That's 250 knots.
Golf Kilo leaving my airspace frequency change approved.
Over the top.
Tower Gulf Kilo frequency change. Cambridge approach Gulf Kilo is type Supermarine Spitfire, 3 miles south of Echo Golf Sierra Uniform, 4,500 feet. Request flight following.
To perform those
Gulf Kilo
all important
approach rolls.
Squawk
2562.
Nose up and around she
squawk goes. Squawk 2562 Gulf Kilo.
Golf Kilo radar contact, 3 miles southeast of Echo Golf Mike Alpha, 2,600 feet. Altimeter tree 0.27.
Airfield. We'll come back and we'll do a
Roger, Golf Kilo.
A tarmac landing, because most people will be doing such landings on tarmac. So I'll bring the boost back down. I'm gonna let the aircraft slow. And there's only one stage of flaps with the Spitfire, and that's just down. Now your flap indicator is that panel there on the wing. At the same time, we'll bring the gear in. Now I've gone a bit long, but if you're not able to keep sight off the runway by moving your head, you can either come offset, or you can do a tight circuit where you just basically look through the quarter lights and continue to keep the runway in visual. We're all right in that respect. So we're still keeping the power at roughly 2600. Our speed's come down to about 100 knots. We've got about 100, let's say 100. We've got 1,000 foot descent rate. We can probably start to slow that down a bit, bring the power back up. I like to try and keep my approaches above 100 knots, but the Spitfire will actually land around about 80 knots. So now I'm going to obscure the runway with the nose. Add a bit of nose up trim. And basically put the nose on the end of the runway and let the aircraft sink. We have a slight wind. It's giving us a slight crosswind. Now that the threshold's coming up, I'm going to reduce the power and let the aircraft sink. I'm coming in quite quick, so I'm going to start the flare now, knock the power off altogether, and basically pitch the nose up. And that is it. Just keeping your toes on the rudder. And let the tail settle. So as the tail settles, bring back the elevator, apply a good amount of back pressure, and she should continue down the runway in a straight direction. Now, braking, if you're like me, you use a trigger on your joystick, a lot of quick taps and should be able to get it stopped in time. One thing I've also noticed, I don't know if it's with this update or with a previous update, but with your rudder input you will get asymmetric braking anyway. So I'm gonna go hard over with the rudder, and as I apply my brakes I'm only getting left hand braking, which is handy because it's allowed me to spin over. One thing I didn't do is to open the canopy on landing. I mean, it's not going to affect us in the simulator, but at any point during landing they would open the canopy, basically to aid quick exit if the engine was to fail. But we're back down on the ground and we're alright. Just gives that wobble pump a wobble. Keep that fuel pressure up. Step ahead out the door. Out the canopy rather. And it's best to if you're ever doing a turn, just to add a bit of power so you get airflow over the rudder. I believe the Spitfire has, I thought it was a fully castering tailwheel or a semi-castering tailwheel. The difference being that the tailwheel will lock in a centre position. And then with an application of brakes or good amounts of force with the rudder, the tailwheel will come out of lock. But don't quote me on that, I don't think the Spitfire has a semi-castering. No one in front of me. And the brakes. I think they actually have, in one of their previous updates to this aircraft, they have reduced the brake force to limit the likelihood of it nosing over. But you can never be too careful. Right, we shall swing around. The tail. What she'll do is that. Apply parking brake. I'll get those flaps back up. We don't need them. And we'll pull the mixture. That is a hopefully a useful video. If you do prefer me doing voiceovers, tutorials, reviews, pop a comment and let me know what you want. I do have a varied amount of aircraft. You'll find me quite often in warbirds, but I'm more than willing to do requests. All right, let's secure the aircraft. The fuel turned off, mags off, and turn the master off. Right, thanks for watching, and don't forget, leave a comment, let me know what you'd like to see. Bye.